for the audience. There are more than 1,000 people here, including the students from primary school, middle school, high school, and universities. And we also have the Dr. Du to be with us as a special guest. As we know, this is actually a well-prepared event for a long time, but for us, we only have a limited knowledge. We only saw the Chinese surgeons on TV. So for our audience, would you please introduce a little bit, what is Chinese surgeons? Why is so important we need to release the Chinese surgeons back to the Yangtze River? So talk about the Chinese surgeon. Actually, it's a I believe it's really enjoyed a long history existing in the earth and it not really changed over the time. So it's more than 140 million years. So talk about the Chinese sturgeons. Actually, there are different species of the Chinese sturgeons in the Yangtze River. And we know this is critically endangered species. Actually, it's the trend in recent years, especially we know in the Yangtze River, the wild Chinese surgeons actually only have quite few little number. So we talk about the wild. Why we talk about the wild Chinese surgeons? Actually, we talk about this is quite special. We talk about the Chinese surgeons. Actually, they spawn in fresh water. And they migrate to salt water to mature, so which means their migration is upstream migration. So that's why we talk about actually they migrate back to the Yangtze River. So this is quite special. This is for the Chinese surgeons. So today, for today's event, we know there will be around 700 Chinese surgeons will be released to the Yangtze River, and they born from 2009 to 2011. So let's have a look at the event venue. Let's look at the settings. I believe there are some ponds for the event. So you can see these are around five big ponds. So the Chinese surgeons to be released right now are in the pond. So we can see the university's students are here and volunteers and also the people from different organizations. I believe they will be in different formations to join the event. And this is countdown to the actual event. So we talk about why we actually release the different age Chinese surgeons. So we talk about actually the Chinese surgeons is facing a critical situation because they are really seriously endangered. So we actually covered five different age group Chinese surgeons to be released today. So for each age group, they can be sustained, developed, or we have the, let's say, new blood coming into the existing family. So yesterday, I also talked to the institute. So we talk about there were 10 large size the Chinese surgeons. So I heard like they fit all of them a male species. So we talk about why we choose the male species with the higher age. So we talk about in the recent years, according to our research, there is a big imbalance in sexual distribution. So we talk about actually there you can find 8 female ones and only 1 male one in the Yangtze River. This is the a racial right now in the Yangtze River, and right now this coming to the a reproduction period. So this is the a big disadvantages. So that's why we release more male ones in order to restore the river population and balance the ratio of male and female species. So the ratio before 7 versus 1. So the look back to the history. The number actually was 1 versus 1, 1 to 1, but right now you can see 7 or 8 female to only 1 male. I believe right now I heard a countdown. I believe maybe the event already kicked off. So we can see the people right now lying in different formations. Let's give our audience a closer look. So the event right now already started. I believe for today the event will last an hour and a half. So we have a plenty of time to give our viewers to enjoy this moment. So I also talked to the volunteers today, actually a lot of young generations. I believe this is for them for the first time to release the Chinese sturgeons. It's a really good time for them to really touch the sturgeon. Actually, we talk about Chinese sturgeons. They're very gentle and a very good temper. And so we talk about what they eat, and we talk about actually for the adult one, they are the a predator, and for the young sturgeons, they feed on aquatic insects. So for today, this group of 700 Chinese sturgeons, before they're to be released, we also give them the a training so they can good enough to live in the wild environment. So we are right now approaching to the releasing site. So we talk about the wild training. So we talk about all these 700 Chinese sturgeons. Actually, they are in captivity. So right now, if we would like to release them to the Yangtze River, so they need to receive the a certain training, so they are good enough, or they know how to exist, or live in the wild environment. That's why before we release them, we change the food, so we feed them different food, especially the food they can familiar with the actual food they can find in the wild environment. So before give them more the artificial food, and right now what we feed them is more the aquatic insects. So we talk about actually step by step. We first cut their fins, and we also actually give them the aquatic easy training, so that's the a entry level, so we give them the a certain cushions. So this is kind of the a cushions, we cut off their fins, they cannot really swim really fast. So we train the Chinese surgeons first to capture these kind of food. So we this kind of like the a lions train their little ones to capture the food in the wild area. So this is step by step. From very beginning, easy ones, easy targets, and then to a higher level of training. So we talk with this group of 700 Chinese sturgeons in different sizes. After we release them to the Yangtze River, we have a certain tracing tag on them, right? So for all these release sturgeons, So what we want to achieve in the end? What's the aim? So they have the tags. So we have three tags. So we have the tag on their body. So during their migration, that may be itself. So that will be a really long time tracking tag. But the good thing is, like, at least we can use this tag to monitor them whether they swim to the Yangtze River, or at least we know their location. So we know exactly at what time, where they swam. And we also have the phone number on each tag. So I heard, like, in certain region, actually, the Chinese sturgeon actually was captured by a fisherman. So that's a story. So they contact us, the fishermen contact us. So they caught one of the Chinese sturgeon and then released it back. So we talk about the Chinese sturgeons in captivity. They are still the Chinese sturgeons.
父母辈啊，他有没有这种，他祖辈有这种回游到海里边的这种能力，对，还能。
And also for the released Chinese sturgeons, they have that capability to swim back to the sea, or they are good enough to live by themselves in the wild environment. So first of all, yes, from freshwater to the salt water, yes, this is their nature. They have that in their DNA.
对，一代一代这个传承下来，他们仍然具备本身所具备的。
So one generation to another generation, they have that capability by nature.
之前我们也听说，我们中华鲟研究所呢，对这些swim
from freshwater to salt water.
通过在淡水当中不断的。
So we talk about DA training before we release them. Actually, we train them, and also actually we also increase the DA concentration of salt in the DA training environment.
海化实验。
Yes, actually, this is kind of the training we let the DA to be released. The Chinese surgeons to be familiar with the salt water. Because for the Chinese surgeons, they migrate to salt water to mature. So we also have the fishermen actually once caught by mistake the Chinese surgeons, which also actually proves the Chinese surgeons released have that capability to swim to the salt water. So I believe everyone is quite ready. For the event, let's give our audience an even closer look at the front seat. So we see the primary school, the universities, and also the staff from the Three Gorges Corporation, and also the people from different walk of life. And let's look at this one. So this is a quite big size one. This is born 2009, around 2 meter long. Weight between, let's say, weight is around 100.
这里边等于每一个池子有大鱼有小鱼也进行了阶梯的分配，是吧？是的。那好，今天我们央视的
So that's around
15 kilograms.
So this is, we have 5 days kind of the pond. So for our viewers, you have this opportunity with CGTN to witness this event. This is the, a closer look at the to be released Chinese sturgeons. There were 700 these kind of Chinese sturgeons to be released today. So they born from 2009. 2011 to 2011, and we also have the one born in 2013. So look at their different size and also different age. We cannot right now identify whether they're a male or a female one. It's so hard to identify just by a glance. We cannot tell by their size or by their weight. So what we can do So actually we can talk about we can do DA more like a operation to tell whether it's a male or a female one, but that should be when they mature and to the reproduction period. So they should be really close to the spawn age. Then we can use either the AB ultrasonic way to tell whether they're male or female one. So we use different tools to help us identify whether it's the a male one or a female one. So we right now at the a activity
event.
So,
you
are watching the A live footage here with CGTN. So, this is a event that 700 Chinese surgeons to be released into the wild. And this happened right now in Yichang City. And you can see there are around 5 to 10 of big pond. And the Chinese surgeons, you can see, they born in 2013, 2014. And also 2011. So you can see they are in different size, in different age. This born around 2011.
我估计要跟您一块儿，咱们也放一放鱼，也做一做这个排班长的活动。
So Dr. Zhu, maybe accompany me to really carry the Chinese surgeons to the final releasing platform. So right now they're carrying the Chinese surgeons from the pond to the platform.
We
talk about today we will release 700 Chinese surgeons in different size, in different age group. And we talk about we also, because they consume. The oxygen, so we need to make sure we have quite evenly distributed a number of Chinese surgeons in different ponds, make sure they have enough air to breathe. So talk about actually they swim so slow, it's true. They only swim slower here. And after release to the Yangtze River, especially after we release them to the Three Gorges River, you can tell they will swim so fast. So they are really strong, especially in the upstream swimming. So maybe we give you our viewers a little video clip. And this is what we got from the Chinese Sturgeon Institution. And this is the first generation of the Chinese Sturgeon. So you look at this as a part of the Chinese surgeons in the captivity, and these the first generation. What is the first generation? Actually, their parents are wild one. So they are the wild ones. Right now, you are looking at the 700 Chinese surgeons to be released. They are the second generation.
Right.
So we talk about actually the Chinese sturgeons released this year. It's the second generation, born around from 2009 to 2014. So they range between 2 to 5 meter land in length, and you need at least 5 adults, human beings, to carry them to weight. So how long they're in the captivity? 20 years for the majority, actually more than 20 years, some even 30 years. So really, this is a good opportunity for our viewers to see this is kind of the sturgeons. That's the second generation. So we also talk about we also have the sonar tag, right? So we have 4 tags. We have the tag on their body, and we also have the in vitro T tag, sonar tag. And also another tag is the molecule tag. Who just touched it? Tell us how it feels. It's very smooth, but for the head, it's a little bit hard. And the pattern is not. It's. It's rough and it's quite in the cold temperature.
So
it's quite smooth and also can feel some texture on its body. So for the textures, this is not what we call the squammer. And for the very smooth part, actually that part not really have the bone flap. For the really tough or the not smooth one, you talk, let's say, their skin covered by the bone flap. So for the bone flap, you can see they're in different pieces, either with the larger size or smaller size.
您也介绍了它是一个底栖型的鱼类哈，刚才看它的腹部肚皮很白。
So look at their bellies in white color.
So this
is a quite larger one. So the volunteers right now they're doing is they bring the Chinese sturgeons to be released from the pond to this platform. So very soon we will release them to the wild. So look at, we have the Fisher Administration vessel also ready on the position. So after, you can look at, this is the tag on their body. And it was also, so that's the PIT tag. So this is a T tag. So we have the T tag that's on their body, that's only maybe last for several months. And we also have another in vitro T tag. So that's at their back muscle, very small one. What about sonar? Sonar tag actually in their belly. So talk about on each Chinese sturgeon, we have at least 3 tags. So we can track their location. And also we have the one more tag, that's the molecular tag.
Yeah.
So we have a 2T tag, we have a sonar tag. And we talk about the fourth one is DNA or the molecular tag.
来，我们看正在放流。我们现在正在收看的是。
So the event, I believe, kicked off right now. You are watching the live stream with CGTN. This is today we have 700 Chinese sturgeons are released into the wild.
现在有一条较大的中华鲟正在。
They are right now will swim to the Yangtze River. These 700 Chinese sturgeons are in captivity, and right now they release to the wild. So you look at their quite gentle, and we can see clearly the yellow tag. That's the T tag.
它不是展开的，因为它很细的一个，横着打的，小写的比较小，写的比较小。
So that T tag actually in the horizontal direction, so you can tell it.So for today, 700 Chinese sturgeons, they received the wild training for 2 months, and we have at least 3 to 4 tags on each Chinese sturgeon, and we have their DNA.
通过这个船
and also we talk about the sonar tag at their belly, so we can right now receive the a sonar signal.
可以工作多久？
And we have the fishery vessels ready on position to receive the sonar signal. And we talk about the A chip inside their body, that's also the in vitro T tag. That's a very small size chip in their body that can work for 20 years more or less.And started from last year, we had the sonar. So that's already 2 years ago. We start to have the sonar tag inside the Chinese sturgeon. I believe this year we can receive the sonar signal. That's the A release the Chinese sturgeons from the fresh water to salt water.So the A stations, very possibly,For the first time, receive the sonar tag. So we talk about Chinese sturgeons. They spawn in fresh water, migrate to salt water to mature. So let's wait and see if they can do the upstream migration. Then that will be the very first time for us to receive the sonar signal from the sonar tag in.The release Chinese sturgeons. So this one, I believe, born in 2013. Range, I believe, around 1 meter. It's very adorable.Very gentle, white belly, you can see their jaw.
它是不是通过触须来感知底下的食物？
包括那上面那些窝窝，那窝窝都是它的嗅觉。
And they use,
serious, 有点像鼻子。
To feel,
鼻孔还要再往后。
鼻孔是这，这是鼻孔。眼前面的两个。
哦，看到了。
The environment, so you can see.
然后它的额头尖尖的，是不是便于它在水里游泳啊？或者
是便于游泳，
便于游泳，
减少水的阻力，
减少水的阻力。
And look at the shape, actually, it's very easy for them to swim in the wild environment. And you can see the acuminate jar. The Chinese sturgeon is really critically endangered, so they need everyone's effort to protect them. So, do you think they will be really easy to get used to the new environment? I believe so.
Because it's in the environment, it's very small. It's
So to give them a little bit of time,
我就有疑问啊,
I'm very soon
to
get used to the wild.
这些咱们人工繁育的中华鲟到了江水里后,
so we talk about the captive Chinese sturgeon. So they will find the direction by themselves or based on the direction of the water. So they will first go upstream or downstream. Normally they will swim downstream. So for some of them, they will swim a little bit around this area. I believe this is also a very good time to educate our young generation. We need to really increase the awareness for the young generation to protect our wild animals. And also we talk about for our young generations, they are really good in the environmental protection or environment conservation.
现在看这个整个的现场特别热闹啊，这既有大朋友有小朋友，尤其我们现在孩子们在这儿，
so you can see we have a lot of people gathering here. So for the egg release, we will divide them in the several batches. So Dr. Du, how long have you been in this career? So I started from 2006, especially for the egg research and preservation of the Chinese surgeons, almost 10 years. The whole career. So at the beginning of 1980 till now, actually released quite a big number of Chinese surgeons to the Yangtze River. The total number around 6 million.
也就是说目前我们了解的数据啊，就是整个长江流域，增殖放流的。So
according to the number we got, the proliferation of Chinese sturgeons that released around 6 million, and 5 million out of this number actually captivated by the Chinese Sturgeon Institute. So any initial results we have? So that's the restore the river population, especially for the wild Chinese sturgeons. And we also should rely on the new technologies to improve our efficiency of the result evaluation. And we have the sonar tag, but the only thing is for sonar tag that only can be sold on the large size Chinese surgeons, and we only adopted this sonar tag in the recent 2 years. We have one question from our viewer. They are asking the wild Chinese surgeons and the captive Chinese surgeons, what are the biggest differences? For the wild one, they reproduce by themselves. And we talk about the captive one. They can grow to the mature age, but they cannot really have that capability for reproduction. So that's why we need human beings to help. And they come to the wild environment, they will very soon have that capability of self-reproduction. So I also would like to share one information. We talk about the emit to downstream of Yangtze River. Actually, we found a spawn area of a Chinese sturgeon. Yes, we have the EA institutions right now are doing the investigation. We didn't have the exact information. But we, can we understand that we actually found that a spawn area of Chinese sturgeons, which means the a wild one and the captive one, maybe they can do the reproduction together, and we cannot come to this conclusion. And that's true, that depend on their capability, depend on the temperature of the river, the water, and also the condition of the water. We talk about the propagation either in the wild way or the captivity. We cannot really tell, actually, because in the end, all these Chinese sturgeons in captivity, after release to the Yangtze River, they become the wild one. Right now, we don't have enough information for us to identify that spawn region. So what we are doing here is we carrying the Chinese sturgeons from this big pond and to the releasing platform. So this morning around 3 a.m. we actually have these 700 Chinese sturgeons carried to the activity site. So the temperature right now for the water is less than 20 degrees Celsius, and the Chinese sturgeons not really like the quite higher temperature, so their extreme temperature is no more than 30 degrees Celsius. So they really like the cool temperature. Another question, talking about the existing situation of the Chinese sturgeons. So right now what we can observe is less than 100 Chinese sturgeons swim back to the salt water. But why they're critically endangered? Number one, of course, the human reasons. Another reason may be overfishing, pollution, and water project construction, too much noisy in the water. So this is the a releasing activity, and the 700 Chinese sturgeons actually they will be released in different batches. And we look at this pond. I believe this is the largest size of the pond. So today you can see we have so many people gathering here. We have the volunteers, we have the students from primary school, middle school, high school, and universities, and also people from all walks of life. And for this temporary pond, we have at least the five size. I believe this one is the largest one. And why this pond is a little bit larger than the others? Because this one we can have more larger size Chinese sturgeons to be released from here. And the event will last more than 1 hour. So that's in the consideration of the safety for the Chinese sturgeons. Make sure they are safe. And also through today's activity is also a way to educate our people, because this is the China's class one protected animals. We would like to through this today's activity to really increase people's awareness to protect the wild animal. So for Dr. Tu, you are in the career for many years. What's your observation?
人们呢主要是过来就是说来看的话
So at the very beginning So people just think, oh, this is something new. But you look at today, for the young generation, they come here. They have a lot of knowledge about environmental protection, environment conservation, and they also ask very professional questions. You can tell through these years' education, people know quite well about preservation of Chinese sturgeons. So let's give our viewers different angles of the a releasing picture.
好，还有一条大鱼，还有一条大鱼，我们把这条大鱼拍完。因为今天这么直观
，So we look at this is another large size one.
庞大的活化石还是很
难得的。So this is a really rare opportunity for our viewers to look at this national treasure. So for this one, I believe that's also born around 2009. So for this pond, specifically for the Chinese surgeons born in 2009 and 2011.
今天我们看我们所研究所的不少工作人员都在现场哈，啊，这一条。
And we also look at we have the A staff from our Chinese Sturgeons Institute.
他比如说要翻身过来是一种什么样的状况？他是在随便的玩一下吗？还是他暂时不适应？
可能因为这个可能环境。
So we look at this one, the with the belly up.So we don't know whether, because this is quite a narrow space. So this is a quite large size Chinese sturgeon. And you look at their body shape, it's really perfect for them to swim in the waters.
这叫硬骨鱼类之间的，它这个尾巴就是很像鲨鱼的尾巴，
像鲨鱼的尾巴。
嗯，所以它这个体型。
So look at the tail is quite like the shark's tail. So this is a perfect body shape for them to swim.
要开装置了，您啊，对。好，我们镜头近一点。镜头，对。好，我们现在我想跟那个杜老师看他的
，Let's hold our breath。
齐北齐这儿这个标，您再给我们解释一下，因为有网友还想关注一下。
这个标就是在挂了外边的体外的标签，这上面有电
话号码。So we talk about the tag. There is a T tag with a phone number on it.
王浩三，我关水了。
At the tail.
我喊了你们叫了往后站，别忘了我喊了你们叫了往后站。
有一位记者这个喊他往后站，但是呢。没有站得太及时啊，是这样啊，我们
So we cannot really stay too close.
应该是体型较大的一条鲟鱼的放流，我们拍摄完了。我们马上还得
So just now we released a quite large size Chinese sturgeon to the wild.
就是还是希望您再把它的
So we also have another question from our viewer.
刚才我们讲，它尾巴上有这个梯形标，包括声呐等等。
We talk about the AT tag at the tail, the sonar tag at their belly.
是不是已经放光了？还有小的，不行了，我们去这边。
So for this one, only have some smaller size Chinese sturgeon. Let's find a pond with a larger size one.
我们来看一眼，有一条大的，我们请。
So there is a large-sized Chinese sturgeon. You can tell there is a yellow tag. That's the T tag at the tail. So the purpose for this T tag is from the releasing moment to the time they are entering to the sea.Hope we can capture their location through this T tag. Of course, this T tag cannot be really with the Chinese surgeons for a long time, but the good thing is at least we can monitor for their location, whether they swim already to the salt water or not. So we talk about there are at least 3 to 4 tags with the release the Chinese sturgeon. We have the T tag and also the a sonar tag. We have the also we talk about their gene tag. So we have just cut a very, very small size from their tail. And we capture in our book, so we know this is the gene tag from which one, because we talk about the T tag either on their tail or inside their body or sonar tag. They cannot really serve through their life cycle, but for our gene tag that can be captured and monitored through the whole life cycle. So we know actually after we capture the image of the release, the Chinese sturgeons, we can from their gene tag to tell whether that's from which generation and they swim to the freshwater or saltwater. This is a vessel. This vessel actually in position to receive the sonar signal. So we have some sonar signal receivers on this vessel. So we can capture their location. And also onshore, we also have the sonar signal station. So for today's these 700 Chinese sturgeons released, we can receive their sonar signals today. And we talk about sonar tag actually only with the larger size Chinese sturgeon. And for the vessel, we also can accompany the large size Chinese sturgeons for a little bit their journey. So we talk about from Yichang to the entry of Yangtze River. Actually, they are swimming in a really large scale of the region. So we talk about the Chinese sturgeons exist from Cretaceous, so they are really enjoy a long history. So we talk about they can grow to around 500 kilograms. So they actually will grow to a very large size, and quite big heavy weight. That's why they can swim to a larger scope of waters. So that's why they can swim to the Yangtze River. So we talk about the Yellow River, the Pearl River. We found the footprint of Chinese sturgeons before, but not in the recent years. Right now, we only can find the Chinese sturgeons in Yangtze River. So we talk about their habitat. Actually, they lost their habitat. And right now, we only can find they're present in Yangtze River. So what we need to do next to protect the Chinese sturgeons? Number one, we should restore the wild environment. And we also need more ways in a holistic way. And we also should have the Chinese sturgeons in captivity for restoring the river population. And we talk about the sampling book, their gene book that should be captured and to be created. This is a quite large scale of system that to be built. So we can have a good result of breed and breeding and preservation of the Chinese sturgeons.
随时随地的出现。我想和您一起，咱们
So we can see we have a lot of keys here today. This is a very good opportunity to educate our young generation.
大家要做什么？是不是要就是等于抬担架？可以这么理解。
So
把鱼抬到那个。
Let's see whether we can carry the Chinese surgeons and to bring them to the releasing platform. So you can see the two boys, they are carrying a Chinese surgeon and bring it to the releasing platform.
对，这个杜博士先来了，来，帮我拿一下我的话筒。我们杜博士，我跟您一块儿。
So I will also a helping hand.
那接下来呢？我们央视新闻的记者王少东现在要和杜博士一起来体验一下这个。
So I will carry one Chinese surgeon and bring it from the pond to the releasing platform.
刚才和杜博士说要一个大个的，来，哎，小朋友小心。
So let's see whether we can find a large size one.
小朋友。来，我们和杜博士一起，这底下都是大一点的吧？对，我们来
这。哎呦，
小心一点，不要太大了吧？太大了，我们俩别抬不动。我们那个镜头，哎呦，我们的镜头给的很直观啊。来，近距离拍摄一下，我们的这条，哎呀
，So this is the one to be released.
我们来看，它确实体型很庞大，这一米多。
So I believe it's more than 1 meter length.
放流池当中。
So let's bring it to the releasing platform.
来，各装置，谢谢，我们有一条鱼要来了。来，请杜博士。
So a deep crowd here.
哎呦！来，我们看一看这一条大个的中华鲟，我们把它放走。
So this is a very large size one.
来了，哎呦，好，哎呀，身体真是滑，好滑。谢谢杜博士。我要说一下直观体验啊，我们还是给这条鱼，因为刚才我们抬的时候，
I would like to share with our viewers. You know, after I touch it, first it's really heavy.
2013-14 的样子。
So this one, more around 2013 to 2014, so the 14 was 1 meter in length and very very slippery.
担架抬的过程当中，感觉到
它自己的力度很大，
它摆尾啊，它晃动，对吧？力度很大。到了水里之后，我相信
是
水里边比较强大的。
So the Chinese surgeon very active. I believe they will be also a active swimmer after they release to the water.
您看，他现在也是在逆流。
Really like to do the upstream migration, so we can tell they also have that capability to go against the current.
好，有外国朋友一起来。
So we talk about the harsh part. That's also the bone flap.That's the bone flap at the back. So that's why their texture, when you touch it, a little bit rough.
我们现在再去选几条小一点的鱼吧。杜博士，我们俩现在身上都是湿的。
So Dr. Du,
我们来选几条小一点的鱼。
We already white. Let's find another smaller size one, maybe.
我们来还到这儿。我们放几条小的，放小的， 来，我们看一看小个的中华鲟。哎呦！
So we found a smaller one.
来，我们的网友展示一下。
So this is a smaller size.
非常的欢实。
Chinese sturgeon.
来，肚皮白白的，啊，它的嘴呢在这个头部的下方，
white belly.
还有四个小小的触须触角。对对，哎呦，好直观，看到这是它的肚皮非常的白啊，尾部还有这个标记。
So look at their belly, and we have the tag on their tail.
放进去吧。
不差鱼了，
来。我说鱼多的是，其实鱼还真挺多的。哎，我们把哎放到这边用这种。哎。有点好，谢谢杜博士。我想问问您啊，这几年您参与放过几次啊？您直接上手的。
So I would like to ask how many time you really participate in the event? So for me, my majority of my job, actually, I'm more like a coordinator, because this kind of activities that really needs a coordinator to really make everything operate in a well-organized way. So we have the volunteers and also the students from universities. So the students from Sanxia University or the Three Gorges University. So this is my third time to participate in this activity. I feel so honored.
是我第三次参加这活动，然后我第一次呢是那个我在大二的时候，然后当时特别幸运。
So for my first time, that's when a second year in the university, I think I'm very lucky.I didn't knew a lot of information about the Chinese sturgeons. And for my second time, actually, I had a visit to the Chinese Sturgeon Institute. That's have a very, very good impression for me. Actually, I know more information from the whole life cycle and how they captivated in the institute. And today is my third time. And I think this is really lucky, so I can participate the third time before I graduate. Yes, really lots of people joined three times. So for the other volunteers, also from the same university, right? And also have a foreign student here. Where from? Hungary.
水利水电工程的学生，大三。
哦，今年大三，在这儿学什么？
I'm from
水利水电。
Bangladesh。
水利水电专业，水利水电是不是跟我们这个
中华鲟
也有一点关系啊？
对对对。
啊，你是
hydropower
中华鲟放流活动吧？
第一次。
Major in hydropower。So this is my first time to participate this activity. How it feels so far?
参加这个活动。
I'm so happy.
长江是中国的母亲河。所以这个
we know the
very important.
Yangtze River. Yangtze River is the a mother river of China. So this activity is so important.
学工作，三峡大学留学生的助习。
哦，留学生的。
Because I'm major in water conservation, conservancy and hydropower.
外国中国朋友，我们一起来加这个活动。
I'm also the a leader of the a student union, so I also have a group of students to participate today's event. So I really would like to say we should use water in the smarter way and protect Yangtze River. So use, start from ourselves, use our actual activity, use our own behavior to protect our mother river. So for our Chinese friends, we're from Gansu province. Actually, we not have a abundant water resources. I really like the Yangtze River. As a student, although I'm not grow up along the coast of Yangtze River, but for a student from the a
water conservancy
and hydropower, I believe, is also a good opportunity for me to make my contribution to protect the Yangtze River. I also visit the Chinese Sturgeon Institute. So actually, our professor introduced the situation of Chinese sturgeon. And we talk about the why they are in critical in danger, because the habitat loss or overfishing, so we should use our knowledge and our action to protect this endangered species. And I also actually see the Chinese sturgeons before in zoos. I believe we should use our activity. And through today's event, to really improve our awareness to protect this species. So we're very glad to see the students from these Three Gorges University, and we also have some young kids here from a primary school, I believe. And group of yours, this group of students from, are also from these Three Gorges University. So you are volunteers? Yeah, we are volunteers. So we actually brought the Chinese sturgeons from the truck to the pond. So our job is more for the transportation. So we are from the civil construction. We have a really naughty one here. This is a really large size one. And this one born in 2009. So this one with T-tag, sensor tag, DA tag, sonar tag, four tags on this one. And this is the largest size one. Maybe not the largest size one, but 10 years old, I believe this one be the oldest one. So to sum up today's event, so Dr. Du, what we should do next? What's your expectation for the future? So we actually do this kind of event for the past 30 years, but still the number of Chinese sturgeons still decreasing. Under this circumstance, we need to do more to protect the Chinese sturgeons and also the species in Yangtze River. You cannot only rely on one institute, that should be really dual the energy across the walks of life. So from our each person's, your activity, your awareness to protect our homeland. Thank you so much, Dr. Du. So today, 700 second generation of Chinese sturgeons are still now releasing into the wild. And these 700 Chinese sturgeons actually are in captivity for restoring the river population. Through today's live stream, we really call on each of us, all our viewers, to pay your contribution to protect our Chinese sturgeons. And this does for this edition of live stream. Thank you so much. Bye for now.